What's going on, guys? It's your boy EP, and we're back again with another video. Guys, shouts out to all 214 of y'all that smashed that subscribe button. We're going by the day, and you guys know I only come out here when I have important news and effective bangers for you guys in the market. So stay tuned. You do not want to miss this video. If you guys are new here, my name is AP. This is It's AP, and where we talk about business, finance, real estate, and the stock market as of late. Guys, make sure you smash that like button, buckle up, and prepare for a banger. This is not financial advice. I am not a financial advisor. This is for entertainment purposes only, yada, yada, yada. Let's get right into it. You guys know why we're here today. Ticker symbol NIO, NIO stock. Full transparency, guys. You guys know I am highly invested in this company. It is one of my top three largest positions in my portfolio. So I am biased, but I want to be very clear. I'm going to go over why I do believe by the end of the year 2025, NIO could be possibly trading at $500 per share. Now, as you guys have seen, we've seen a big, massive pullback in the market. So any growth stocks, spec stocks, tech have taken a huge hit in this correction over the last month and a half or so. So we've seen NIO pull back all the way down to, I've seen $32. So we saw a bottom out of $32. I really hope you guys have been loading up in the interim while we're having these massive buy opportunities for now. Because I want to be clear, over the next 8 months, whatever happens with NIO stock, I'm just buying. I have just simply been buying NIO shares left and right. It goes up, I buy. It goes down, I buy. I'm simply acquiring shares every time there is income or any type of inflow of funds that comes into my account. I'm simply just dispersing them as they come in. And a lot of the portions are going towards NIO shares. So I was able to scoop a lot at $32, and I'm still buying here at $41.36. We sit here today on April 28th, Wednesday, April 28th. We have earnings calls. We have the NIO earnings call tomorrow. But I want to hop on here to let you guys know, good or bad, this is what I'm doing. Now, hey, you guys want to know, AP, how the hell are you? Can you justify a $500 price target for NIO in less than 5 years? And this is what I want to tell you guys right now. So a $500 price target for a company like NIO would represent roughly a market cap of over $700 billion, right at $720 roughly. So how the hell can I justify that? Well, first I want to go by, I like justifying things with comps. Comps being reasonable entities or businesses that share similar models, that I can base it off of, like a mother comp. And we know the main comparable to NIO is whom? Oh, that's right, Tesla. Tesla Motors is also at a market cap of roughly $700 billion. At their peak, they've exceeded that. So right now, we're looking at Tesla at right around a $700 billion market cap, in which NIO would have to have the same market capitalization to get to that $500 a share mark, which is insane to think or to say. It's insane to say right now. And you don't see a lot of YouTube videos speaking or as bullish as this on the NIO share, because it's just sitting at $41 a share. And I'm telling you today that roughly in less than 5 years, we can potentially be looking at $500 for each share of NIO. So I'm making sure I'm allocating a decent amount of my funds to my higher conviction positions, thus being NIO. So once again, Tesla, let's just call it a $700 billion market cap on any green day, any given day, $700 billion market cap. NIO right now sitting at a $59 billion market cap, $41 a share roughly. I'm not gonna waste your time, because you guys know the ins and outs of NIO. You guys seen all the partnerships they've been releasing all the news of the partnerships that have been going on as of late in the past couple months with Ford and different oil companies that are simply just breaking the news and have been actually running the stock down. But nonetheless, this is what we're going to be taking a look at here today. NIO, a company that has delivered 44,000 vehicles in the year of 2020. They recently hit their 100,000 vehicle production mark, in which Elon obviously congratulated them because that is no short task. That is a very, very difficult thing to do because once again, in this electric or this EV space, it's not so much the demand is the problem, is can you meet that demand, the supply? And if you guys don't remember, 6 years ago, Elon was at the butt of all the jokes because we were dreamers thinking and investing in Tesla a few years ago. Tesla was one of the heavily shorted stocks only a few years ago. Because, and the main reason why it didn't have the backing of those large hedge funds and institutions was because they simply hadn't shown that they could meet demand. Yes, you have a cool car. Yes, it's electric. Yes, the demand is there for it. Can you meet demand? Can you produce and can you deliver? Keyword deliver. So I want to point out Tesla, established in 2003, it took them up until roughly mid-2015 to deliver 50,000 vehicles in one calendar or fiscal year. And essentially, that was 12 years. And now NIO on year six has done this, roughly. So, and once again, just for comparison, Tesla in year 10 delivered about 22,000 vehicles. Tesla in year 10 delivered about 22,000 vehicles. And once they showed that they could meet demand, their stock prices began to surge. Actually, once the report broke that they actually did deliver those 22,000 vehicles, the stock surged about 16%, and they started getting the backing and the investment of those mainstream, of those larger institutions, and it made them believers. So it's as simple as that. We want to boil it down to basic numbers, basic mathematics, basic calculations. The demand is there. That's not the problem. And then you may ask, well, why hasn't Cathie Wood herself, the one that invested in Tesla, why hasn't she made her investment in NIO? Keep in mind, NIO is a Chinese company. There is a lot of skepticism there. There's a lot of hesitancy to just invest your money into a Chinese company. And I can almost assure you, Cathie Wood's in her own little Robinhood or Webull portfolio. Oh, FYI, guys, check the description, link in the description down below. Get your free stocks at Webull. Get some free cash from M1 Finance. Everything's down below. Make sure you check all that out. And cryptocurrency, BlockFi's down below. Shameless plug, my bad. Anyway, I can almost assure you Cathie Wood's in her own personal portfolios has NIO shares. But as far as letting them into the ARK Invest fund, that's a different story. Because once again, the moral of the story, show me the money. Show me the deliveries and then they will back you up. Show them you can deliver. They have no concerns about demand. China has made it abundantly clear. They want every other automobile to be electric in their country by the year 2035. They have implemented subsidies to essentially credit citizens to buy electric vehicles, or NEVs they call them, new energy vehicles. So the point is, they're not only incentivizing these individuals to purchase electric vehicles by giving them, let's just call them tax incentives or tax breaks by doing this, getting money back. Let's just call it a free tax refund. When you buy an electric vehicle, they really were giving back, or they are doing it right now. And they've extended this program up until the year 2022, roughly almost $3,000 they were getting back just by purchasing one of these electric vehicles. And they actually made it to where these tax benefits or these credits, subsidies, they actually made it to where these subsidies were primarily or structured for electric vehicles, essentially, that were capable of the battery swap technology. Are you guys starting to catch a hint there? Wink, wink. Get a NIO? Wink, wink. Listen, it is no coincidence. NIO, we understand NIO is backed by the government. They're indirectly, they're directly backed by the Chinese government. China wants their own EV champion. China wants to go electric. And they are going to crown their champion, be it NIO, be it XPeng, be it Li Auto. I do believe that NIO will be that front runner, but obviously it would be smart to have exposure to all three, which I do. But I do believe that front runner will be NIO, as NIO aims to take up market share in the luxury EV space. And we're talking about China once again. Tesla is where it is. They just pumped out 500,000 vehicles just this past year. Majority, obviously, in America. Now, we want to think about how large China is and the opportunity that NIO has to take a market share, obviously, for their country and going into Europe. So we have, it boils down to a simple math equation. As long as they can deliver, can you produce? Show me the money, show me the deliveries, and then you'll get the backing. Tesla has obviously expanded and ramped up production. They have numerous factories across the nations, and we need to see that NIO is able to ramp up as aggressively as they have been year over year, increasing 114% fold each year over year. Now, if they can keep that up, they will in fact catch Tesla within the 5 years. And this price target of mine will actually be undervalued if they can keep up with the pace, if they can keep up with their year over year growth. Now, I can go into all the partnerships, like for example with Ford, that NIO are coming into terms with that make NIO the clear-cut champion or the perceived champion for the going forward for the future, as they are building a foundation for success, for long-term success. So if you want to see those videos, you want to see a deep dive going into the new and recent partnerships that they're signing with, that are coming on. There's going to be a whole lot more partnerships, by the way, guys. So just wait on it. And with the Chinese government once again backing them, we're going to see them incentivize their citizens to get an electric vehicle by giving them basically cash back when they buy these electric vehicles. And then eventually, what happens is battery as a service, the goal is to implement a lifestyle change to their customers and their client base. Just like here in America, which most of my viewers are in America, just like most of you guys have an iPhone. And then you may have the Apple Watch and the AirPods and whatever. So I know that I won't be switching to an Android anytime soon, more than likely never. And that's why another one of my positions, my largest positions, is Apple stock. So keep in mind, guys, they're going to try and implement here a lifestyle change in the electric vehicle space to their clientele, to where they cannot see themselves owning any other vehicle than a NIO automobile. Now, you guys know I like to keep these videos short and sweet. And if you guys truly want me to go into a deep dive video, because I can talk about this for hours, guys, but I just wanted to get on here and let you guys know what I've been doing and what I am doing. I'm going to be tuning in for the earnings call tomorrow. In the short term, there's going to be a lot of volatility in NIO over the next 12 to 24 months. But if you know and see the value here in NIO stock, you will hop in right now and you would buy, hold, average down. And what I want you guys to do right now, in the comment sections below, let me know your average cost per share, how many shares you have, and if what you'll be doing. And if you're buying more, if you're just holding tight, if you're selling, let me know what you're doing. And I'll let you guys know what I'm doing, because I'm just simply averaging. I'm averaging up now because I got in pretty early, but I'm just consistently buying because it's at an extremely undervalued. And once again, guys, the big takeaway from this is that we go to the moon, per call it, and we per se go to the moon when NIO proves that they can deliver at all time levels. When they show they can run with the big dog, as in Tesla, because there's no telling how big and how large Tesla will be in 5 years, obviously. But there's so much room to grow, and they're in a market, they're in the largest market in the world, guys. So it's pretty straightforward. As long as they can deliver, That's what Cathie Woods wants to see. That's what the large institutions want to see. Show me the deliveries and they'll show you the funds to back you up and get you to where you want to go. And that's the moon. So simply, guys, make sure if you do one thing for me, if you appreciate this video, you go ahead and smash that like button for me, please. Hit that subscribe button. Comment down any questions you may have. I reply to all comments. Any questions you may have, smash that post bell, hit that bell, and let so you are notified every single time that we post a video, because I come on here when it's only for gems, and I'm not going to let you guys miss out on the big opportunity, and you guys will thank me later, because in 5 years, you're more than likely going to be a wealthy individual if you invest correctly with NEO stock and a lot of the companies we talk about on the channel. But without further ado, it's your boy AP, and until next time, peace.